This right here goes to all the Muslim leaders in the world. You're all cowards. Every single last one of you. Every single one of you are responsible for everything that we see today. And the past leaders are responsible for that too. Everything that's going on, the blame game that you guys are playing, blaming America, blaming Israel, blaming this person, blaming that person. Tell me where in the beginning of Islam was the blame game used? Where is it in our religion that we're supposed to look to blame other people in order to fix our problems? Where does that come from? Everything about our religion tells us that any problems that we have comes from ourselves. And any problems we have, if we can't solve them, we're supposed to do inner reflection. We're supposed to look within ourselves, see if there's something wrong with us in our character and what we are doing that's not allowing us to be successful. Everything about our religion tells us that any problems that we have comes from ourselves. And any problems we have, if we can't solve them, we're supposed to do inner reflection. We're supposed to look within ourselves, see if there's something wrong with us in our character and what we are doing that's not allowing us to be successful. What Islam do you guys follow? I don't understand. Do you just follow what you hear? Just repetition over and over again? Don't you know what embellishment is? Don't you know that over the course of many years, things get embellished and changed because of political discourse and different countries and infighting and all these different things? Have you guys studied? Have you guys read? Do you look at things in context? Do you take verses out of context from one battle or one political treaty that got broken and then use it for every single situation and say that this is what we need to do? Why are Muslims, any Muslims, burning the tombs of the prophets? Where the hell is this coming from? What kind of Islam is this? The tomb of Joseph, peace be upon him, was just burned. Do you know what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said about Joseph? That he was the best person when they asked him who was the best of people? And he said, Joseph, the son of Allah's prophet, the son of Allah's prophet, the son of Allah's intimate friend, Abraham, peace be upon him. Have you not read that? Have you not read in the Quran that, let me tell you the best of stories, the story of Joseph, peace be upon him? And there's Muslims out there burning his tomb. Why? What is this? What religion? Why are Muslims, any Muslims, burning the tombs of the prophets? Where the hell is this coming from? What kind of Islam is this? The tomb of Joseph, peace be upon him, was just burned. Do you know what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said about Joseph? That he was the best person when they asked him who was the best of people? And he said, Joseph, the son of Allah's prophet, the son of Allah's prophet, the son of Allah's intimate friend, Abraham, peace be upon him. Have you not read that? Have you not read in the Quran that, let me tell you the best of stories, the story of Joseph, peace be upon him? And there's Muslims out there burning his tomb. Why? What is this? What religion? I want people to understand. I want Muslims to understand this. Pause for a second before you think that I'm some sort of Muslim that is getting influenced. I'm not getting influenced by anybody. I read and study for myself, and I want you to understand something. We have one. Over 1 billion Muslims that live in this world, on this planet right now. And the Islam that you practice, I'm talking to the peace-loving, everyday, go-to-work Muslim that believes in peace and just dialogue and intellectual discussion and nonviolence. The Islam that you understand is different from the Islam of the terrorist. Don't feel like you need to defend them. You don't. Their Islam, their understanding of Allah is totally different from yours. It's not real Islam. Study the history. There's always been extremists from the beginning. This is a problem. We've always had this problem. And every religion has it. But look within our own religion. Just focus on yourself right now and understand that we need to deal with our own problems before we can start pointing the fingers like babies to everyone else. They have their own problems too. And I can't address other people's problems for them until I address the problems for my own people first. Because there's problems with them too. There's problems with every nation. But I can't talk about it. You can't talk about it until you fix your problems first. And I see Muslims talk about our problems, but it's not as much as it should be. It should be 100% of our focus on that, and don't worry about what other countries do. If we need to self-defense or defend ourselves and defend our borders, we'll do that just like they have to do for themselves. But right now, you need to focus on this insane problem, and the biggest blame goes on the Muslim leaders of the world. You're all cowards. You're all phonies. You say you take money from countries that you hate. You say America did this, but you took the money. You say that America put this in our situation, but you took the you work with them. You work with the politicians. We see all the pictures. We know about all these people. All these, there's no need to get into it. It's so in your face, but yet people just don't digest it. You can't take the apple from the tree and then blame the devil for all your problems. You participated. You don't have to. Focus on fixing your country. Focus on not being dictators and these money hungry, power hungry individuals that look to everyone else and say, look, this guy caused our problem, and that guy did it, and he did it, and he did it. Meanwhile, you're taking money and you're flying in million-dollar jets and living in luxury while your people are suffering. Think about this for a second. If you had a family member that was suffering that you loved, do you feel comfortable flying in million-dollar jets, living in luxury hotels and palaces while your family member is suffering? And then going on the news and saying, look, my people are suffering. Can you do that? Can you do that as a human being? If you really cared about your brother or sister or family member and you saw them suffering, crying, bleeding, dying, and can you sit in the lap of luxury and can you be taken seriously? Why should we take you seriously? Why? And the biggest blame goes on the Muslim leaders of the world. You're all cowards. You're all phonies. You say you take money from countries that you hate. You say America did this, but you took the money. You say that America put this in our situation, but you took the you work with them. You work with the politicians. We see all the pictures. We know about all these people. All these, there's no need to get into it. It's so in your face, but yet people just don't digest it. You can't take the apple from the tree and then blame the devil for all your problems. You participated. You don't have to. Focus on fixing your country. Focus on not being dictators and these money hungry, power hungry individuals that look to everyone else and say, look, this guy caused our problem, and that guy did it, and he did it, and he did it. Meanwhile, you're taking money and you're flying in million-dollar jets and living in luxury while your people are suffering. Think about this for a second. If you had a family member that was suffering that you loved, do you feel comfortable flying in million-dollar jets, living in luxury hotels and palaces while your family member is suffering? And then going on the news and saying, look, my people are suffering. Can you do that? Can you do that as a human being? If you really cared about your brother or sister or family member and you saw them suffering, crying, bleeding, dying, and can you sit in the lap of luxury and can you be taken seriously? Why should we take you seriously? Why? This is a message directly to Muslims. Fix yourselves. Fix your situation. Talk to other Muslims. Study. Research. Check context. Look at what Islam is supposed to be. Islam was a progressive idea. It brought laws and civilization to uncivilized barbarian people. Separate the conflicts that our religion went through in its early period for what it strived to accomplish. What it strived to accomplish is what Islam is. That's the root of Islam. That's the heart of Islam. Understand this. Understand your history. Study, research. You'll find the answers. Assalamu alaikum.